Hello, church family. I'm here with a missionary here in Ethiopia named Samuel Olto, and he is with E3 Partners and has had some incredible experiences in his life, and I've just asked him to share a little bit with us about his life and kind of how he came to faith in Christ, and specifically some of the persecution and imprisonment you mentioned at lunchtime that you had experienced. And I think my family back home in America would be very interested to hear the things that you were sharing with me. So do you mind just kind of sharing with us for a few minutes?
Yes, please. It's my pleasure to share what God does in my life and what he did through. Because of persecution, when we say, it's important to understand how the church passed through in Ethiopia during a communist government, which means the government denies the existence of God since 1975 up to 1991. For 18 years, Ethiopia has been led by a government which denies the existence of God and closes mission stations, Bible schools, churches, whatever what the Bible talks about, and then persecuted Christians. During that time, I became Christian because of that I have been learned about Marxism-Leninism and materialism, which denies the existence of God. So they taught us at school that there is no God. So my mind searched about the existence of God. Number one, because of calendar, about BC and AD. BC before birth of Christ, and AD and Domino after birth of Christ. This is the history which I learned. So why do they deny? So I heard from my friend that Jesus loves me, and he died for my sins, and also he takes me to heaven after death. Then this answers my question and my need about the peace and satisfaction of life. Then I decided in 1977, I accepted Jesus as my Savior, and then I started following Jesus. That is the reason why government put me in jail five times, sometimes for 3 months, sometimes for 7 months, for 15 days. I have been in jail. And that was, you know, some of Christians was being killed, ministers. But I was a teenager and I started following Jesus. And then I decided if I die, let me die, because anybody is dying. So that was my decision, and my concern was just to see Jesus and to follow him. And because my questions were answered, and I satisfied, my soul, you know, satisfied. And then I have time to follow Jesus and to start Bible study. I did the study by myself. And then that helped me also to help my friends at back in my area. So I started grouping and teaching and leading others.
Okay, well, Samuel, can you explain some of the details of your imprisonment, how you were arrested, what happened while you were arrested, your treatment during that time in prison?
Yes, you know, we have punishment. We had punishment in prison, you know, lack of food, you can't bathe, you can't be free with no rest, no sleeping area. And there are many problems and hard works and loading, many things. So that was some of so whipping and, you know, kneel down and having punishment. And then they ask us to deny Jesus, not to follow Jesus, and not to read again the Bible, not to teach, to share others. Those were questions to be asked us to deny. And then we said no, we refused to answer what they needed. So they put another special punishment areas, prisons. So they did that sometimes in highlands, in cold area, sometimes in lowlands, you know, in hot areas, without refreshing, without, you know, enough room to sleep and to sit. and with hard works. So that was the time which really I was being many times, you know, tested. But I expected just if I pass, let me be. So that was the time that God changed us, changed the government situation, changed everything. Now it is time for us to worship God and to share the faith, what we have with our friends. During that time, I was testing also, looking for, you know, I was ready for marriage and looking and praying to God, whom I marry. So some of girls came in prison, you know, I was looking for who has really Christian, you know, bold Christian, you know, who does not deny because of persecution. So I met my wife, I saw her and her patience and her faith, and then I chosen her. Yeah, this will be my wife for future. Mm-hmm. Then that is one of the amazing thing which I recognized her there in prison. Because of persecution, everybody was, you know, some of them denying, some existing and resisting the persecution and staying by faith.
Samuel, I'm curious, from your time in prison, when you came out, did you find that your life was closer to the Lord, that you had more passion for serving God, or did you leave prison feeling defeated and regretting that time that you had spent?
The decision made, you know, in the beginning, then when I accepted Jesus, I realized that Jesus died for my sins, and I am free, and I have, you know, eternal life, and the meaning of life was there. So I was happy. And then I decided to just whatever God wants to be in my life. Then that helped me to be victorious over the persecution. Even if I had any problem, God was giving me resistance and ability and patience, and also helping me through difficulties. Sometimes I face soldiers helping me. And instead of whooping, beating the lands, and instead of, you know, working, giving me hard work, they were talking and be patient with me. Also, I saw the hand of God through, and that some also bring food for me from different angles. Sometimes it's a miracle. God was helping through that persecution also. So I saw God's hand, and I wasn't denied. I stayed, and I was waiting God's, you know, looking as his time. So he did, and he was faithful for me.
Praise God.
Amen.